Yo, what is up, guys? Mr. The Reverts here. Welcome back to the channel. Ladies and gentlemen, yesterday was an absolutely huge day for the Call of Duty scene because it was part one of the live event Easter egg, which of course Nuke Verdansk killed all the zombies. But after that, we are kind of left on a little cliffhanger. We don't know what's going to be happening come later today. However, what we do know is the only map available to play right now is Rebirth Island, which is set in the nighttime. But the COD community was actually doing a bit of research and discovered this new website called rebirthfromtheashes.com, and it does have kind of like, I guess, a little correlation to Rebirth Island because I mean they have the same name and whatnot. But we do have at the very top here four objectives that need to be completed. Now along the way you can type in other various codes that will bring up screenshots of the new Warzone map set in the 1980s, which I do have screenshots of for you guys, and the ones I could find are airport, stadium, farmland, superstore, array, hospital, and downtown. Now there are other screenshots of the new operator Wraith, and then this other mysterious operator that shows up if you type in a ghost, and then a red door as well. But I'm not sure what all those mean, but if you ask me, I think they are kind of like little fillers for this Easter egg. They're not too important, so I wouldn't worry too much about them. But anyways, moving on to the actual steps for the objective, you first have to listen to this audio message.
You made it this far. Now it's time to go a little further. This is where the real work begins. Do you have the codes from the radio towers? Let's get you scanned in and verified. I'll try and connect you with the others securely, but the intel I had is unscrubbed. It's raw. Don't say we didn't warn you.
Now for the first objective, you have to type in the code Guardian, which will then prompt you to turn on your webcam, and then you have to follow the mysterious man's on-screen instructions to turn your face to the left and right, and then after completing that task, you will then be granted this pretty cool security clearance tag, and if you wish to, you can share this onto your social media pages or set it as your iPhone screen background to kind of be like a security clearance card. But yeah, after that, you have now finished the first objective. Moving on to objective number two, this is probably the most tedious one out of the four. So first off, you have to type in parallax, and after that, you then need to break the code, which the code is going to be the star symbol 1984 and then the hashtag. And the reason why it's kind of super duper tedious is because the numbers on this hexagon are super super tiny. So I recommend zooming in on your page to make it a bit easier for you, and you can also use the wheel of your mouse to scroll in and enlarge the digits on the hexagon. So yeah, once you type in the code there, you get this weird animation, which I think may be part of the new Verdansk deployment animation. I don't know, but yeah, still pretty cool there. And the next for objective three, you have to type in the code Paradigm, which will then give you this confirmation lockdown menu. So after that, you just hold down a random key on your keyboard, and that's going to bring up this identification verification screen, kind of like a Google CAPTCHA type deal. So just follow the on-screen instructions, keep holding down the keys until you do it again, and just repeat that same process. And after you do that, it will then show you this image of what appears to be the brand new Gulag for Verdansk 1980s. And if this rings any bells, this is actually a remake of Standoff from Call of Duty Black Ops 2. So Standoff is going to be the new Gulag come tomorrow. I am super, super hyped. Standoff is one of the best maps ever have been created in a Black Ops history, and we are going to be getting this in the form of the new Gulag. I cannot wait to get my hands on this new map. And then finally, for the last objective, you are then going to type in the code Oblivion. So once you do that, click on allow location access, and that will then prompt you to interact with this map of various different locations, and one of which upon clicking will show a video clip of what I think is a trailer for the new Warzone map. Now inside of this control center that's showed in the clip here, it does kind of resemble Summit to me from Black Ops 1, but I don't know. Please tell me your thoughts about this down below in the comments, guys. It does kind of look like Summit, but I'm not too sure because it's not, you know, snowy and whatnot. We do see the gondola there. So again, please tell me your thoughts about this down below in the comments, guys. But the last code to type in to fully complete the steps is Atlantis, which lastly gives you these two on-screen boxes, one of which is the little ring dial from the previous steps, and then this little chat box here. I'm not not too sure what any of these two do or what they mean. I think we are gonna learn more about these two boxes come later today and possibly in the future. Like, they could come back to this same exact site here and use it for future Easter eggs. Who knows? But yeah, definitely don't think we're done here with this Rebirth from the Ashes website, but for now, we are. So we do get this countdown timer for the start of part two for the Warzone Live event. And right now on Rebirth Island, there are some kind of like these weird screen glitches going on that give you a number sequence, which is kind of strange. And also those red phones, they also are getting like phone calls from them. And then they also list off a number code right there. So there's definitely more to come here and a lot more work needs to be done. And I think we're gonna find more about this come later today, guys. The last thing I would like to touch base on is mistakes were made over on the developer's end, because once you were able to install and play the new 1.16 update, if you were able to get a full private match lobby going, you were actually able to play on the brand new Verdansk 84 map. Like, the actual new map was playable for a short period of time, but they have since then removed private matches from Warzone. So sadly, I will not be showing any footage of that here on the video because of copyright reasons, but it's all over the internet. There's footage there, the map, the new locations, everything. So yeah, if you guys want to, you know, take a look, you can do so, but you know, just be warned of spoilers because it's out there. And if you guys are reposting that stuff, then be warned of copyright because your stuff will definitely get taken down. So yeah, those are my warnings, guys. Be careful if you don't want to, you know, be spoiled for the new map and the new locations, because it is flooded over on Reddit and Twitter. So with that, guys, please tell me your thoughts about this down in the comments. Love you all so much. Have a great rest of the day. Till next time, I'll see y'all later.